Problem number 4. Solve by factoring. We have 2x squared plus 7x plus 3 equals 0. So this is still a trinomial, but this time we have a coefficient of 2. So I choose still to use the Columbian method, but I am going to add 2 more steps, one in the beginning and one at the end. So if I wanted to use the Columbian method, and remember there are more than one factoring method out there, you just need to get good with one of them. So with my method, I have to multiply the first term by the coefficient and the third term by the same coefficient, in this case 2. And I'm just going to rewrite my problem. So 2 times 2 is 4. Everything else stays the same, so my middle term comes down, and then 3 times 2 is 6. Now I can use the same steps as I used before, so I'm going to write my empty sets of parentheses, and then I'm going to square root my first term, so the square root of 4x squared is 2x, and I'm going to write that twice. Then I'm bringing down my first sign. I'm multiplying the signs together to give me the second sign, so positive times positive is a positive. And then I'm going to look at the last number, or the third number, which is 6, and I'm trying to find the factors, same signs in here, so the factors must add to give me the middle number, which is 7. The only factors I could think of that will add to give me 7 are 6 and 1. 6 times 1 is 6, and 6 plus 1 is 7. The larger of the two factors goes first, and the smaller one second. So previously, when we have a coefficient of 1, we would be done, but because we multiplied by 2 in the beginning, we have to divide by 2. Only one of these two binomials is divisible by 2, and this would be the left side. So we're dividing by 2, or the factors of 2, so I can put a 1 here. And now 2 divided by 2 is just x, 1x, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. Then anything divided by 1 just stays itself. So I can bring that down, and all that is equal to 0. So now we can use the zero product rule, and we can set each binomial equal to 0 to find our solution, and also 2x plus 1 equals 0. Solving for x, I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides, and that leaves me with x equals negative 3. Now on the right side first, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides, and I have 2x equals negative 1, and then I'm going to divide by 2 on both sides, and my answer is x equals negative 1 half. So my final solution to this equation would be x equals negative 3, and x could also equal negative 1/2.